Yo, what's up? Shark Gaming here, back with another video, and today I'll be talking about the new v4.6.0 update coming on the 25th of June. I mean, it all depends on your area code and your time zone, but yeah, it's universal 25th of June. So Konami will be rewarding everyone with a free Black Ball agent once you update your game, but don't get ahead of yourself now. Don't get too excited, because there's still a possibility that you as a new player will be going for Messi or Cristiano Ronaldo or Neymar, Suarez, Aubameyang, Lewandowski, Lukaku, and they end up getting like a burnt Leno or one of those players that, you know, you'd really use in the game. Alongside that, this is week 2 of the 25th anniversary 300 million download mobile campaign, and we are going to get 3 new featured number 10s. These cards will include Lionel Messi, Marcus Rashford, and Mesut Ozil. The featured Lionel Messi is maxed out at 100 at right wing forward, centre forward, and cam, 99 at second striker, and 95 at left wing forward. As per usual, Messi is a very creative player and also has the roaming flank trait, so we know he's going to cut in from the wing to collect passes and maybe deliver a spectacular shot, meaning that he can curl it or some power shots, or he could just provide a cheeky assist. It all depends on what you want to use him for. The Marcus Rashford now is maxed at 98, and I can't wait to use him because this card is very special to me. I've had the gold ball version and 3 different featured versions of the Manchester United club selection, and all 4 of those cards have been amazing for me. And up front, he can provide up front, meaning center forward, even attacking mid forward, and he can provide on the flanks or the wings, so he can be a left mid forward, a right mid forward, a right wing, or a left wing. The thing is that Konami has given him the gold pouch trait. So you know that more than likely he's gonna be on the shoulder of the last defender, looking to make a run so that he can score. And majority of the time his runs are very, very good, whether it wants to be over the top or ground balls. And trust me, he's very aggressive. So at the same time, I really, really like playing him. His stats are pretty decent, and we know his runs are killer on the counter. He's filled with tricks and even has knuckle shot and dipping shot ability, so he's able to slap decent shots from way out. So he's not one of those strikers that you can only depend on like in front of goal. He can do it from far out as well, as we saw against Chelsea when he did that wonder free kick. But yeah, Mesut Ozil now, on the other hand, is maxed at 95, and he's a creative playmaker. Ozil to me is the most natural playmaker in the game, as he's always searching for ways to assist your forwards, using his many passing traits such as pinpoint crossing, weighted passing, one touch pass, no look pass, through pass, etc. The only negative to this card, and this is in my opinion now, because obviously I haven't used him as yet and the stats are different from what you would think, but from my experience in using Ozil, he is more of a playmaker, as in he's like 95% playmaker and 5% like striker, meaning that he'll more make a lot of passes perfectly and then the shot won't really come off that good. His finishing is saying around 81 to 83, and his speed has suddenly increased because his regular black ball card, I don't think it's 82, and even if he's that fast, the problem is that his stamina is very low on the base card. In this one, his stamina is pretty decent, so it's a change, but it's not really that much of a change. At the same time, he's not complete in the point where you have Messi or De Bruyne or Marco Reus, and you know that they can offer some killer shots on target and they're like 60% playmaker, 40% center forward. Nah, Ozil is just mostly playmaker. If you want a pass, like if you want to pop a pass out of nowhere, Ozil is your guy. So at the same time, that's just like a couple negatives for the card, but apart from that, I think I'm gonna have use for every single card. Obviously, I can't put them all in one side, but for multiple sides. But yeah, that's just that on that, really. That's, you know, the other things are the usual match day events. So, you know, double the coins. So once you have 900 written up, you're going to get 200 coins by the end of that. I don't really know how helpful that is. We're going to get three different iconic moments packs, which are listed right here. I'm still waiting for the free packs that I read Konami was supposed to give us. So whenever that is coming, you know, I'll update you guys on that. You know, special trainer galore and some other little challenges that don't really contribute to anything. So basically, this is just the video, and I really hope that I explained a lot for you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more updates. I'm out.